Okay, so after front office is done checking in the patient, the super bill is going to print out, and then front office will hand it to back office. So then on the chart, you're just going to look at their vital sign and see what the normal vital signs are. So we take height, weight, temperature, pulse, respiration, and we take their blood sugar if they're diabetic. And then at this time, we also look if there's any labs ordered. If the labs are ordered and they haven't been printed yet, you would print them out and then put them in the chart. So usually I write all of the information here, so when you take their vitals, you don't forget one and bring them back. So right now we're just gonna go call the patient in the waiting room. Normally, if it's a new patient, we take their height again, but if it's an old patient, we don't have to. But just for practice, I'll show you how to do it. So here's our ruler that we use. So for the ruler, you just put it out and pull up. Make sure the ruler is flat on the floor, and make sure that he's standing on the floor, not the scale. So you just lean it up against the wall. And ask the patient to stand back, and then you're gonna measure their height. And then after you get it level to their head, you're gonna ask them to step up. And then you're gonna look at the number below here. So on the left side is shown in inches, and the right side is shown in centimeters. So 68 inches would be 5 feet 8. And then for the weight, we ask them to step on the scale. And then for the weight, we're aiming for this to be balanced around here. So normally I look at his regular weight and base it up around there. So what's your regular weight?
Close to 150. Mm-hmm. Below that.
Okay, so the bottom one, I'm on 100 pounds. And then the top one, I'm at 48, so you just add them together and it's 148. And then afterwards, you ask them to step off, and then, sir, I'll be taking your blood pressure in here. And then since he's wearing a long sleeve, you ask him to roll up his sleeves. And then if it's impossible to roll it up to the point where it's constricting his blood flow, you could also do blood pressure over his shirt, but only if it's a thin shirt. If it's really thick, you're going to have to ask him to change. And then for the blood pressure cuff, there's a artery line. So we just take this little arrow and then we line up this brachial artery, which is around here. And then you just make sure it's snug. General rule of thumb is you should be able to put two fingers in here, but it should be tight enough where it doesn't roll around when you're touching it. And then after you put out, make sure the feet are flat on the floor, and make sure the arm is relaxed on the chair. And then to start, you just turn it on. And once it shows this, you can take their vitals and you just press this button to take their blood pressure. Make sure the patient isn't talking during this time or else his blood pressure is gonna constantly fluctuate. And then while he's taking his blood pressure, you're gonna take his temperature. So the temperature probe is just right here. So you're just gonna remove the probe. And then you're gonna stick it in one of these plastic things. You're going to push it in tightly to make sure it's secure. And then you're going to make sure it's in Fahrenheit, and you're going to make sure it says oral. And then you're just going to put it below his tongue and then close his mouth. number and then you dispose of it by opening the trash can and then just clicking this and you can put it back in. At the same time, your blood pressure should be finished. So his blood pressure is 120 over 71, and his heart rate is 78, which is very normal. And then for his respiration, usually you can do it multiple locations, but usually I leave their blood pressure cuff on and I leave the temperature probe in their mouth and I would just observe how many times they're breathing. And you shouldn't tell patients that you're recording this or else they'll change, they'll be conscious of the way they breathe and they'll change. So one breath count, we count it as one inhale and one exhale. So usually you can look at their stomach or you can look at their shoulders. So that's just inhale, exhale. And then you would count it in 15 seconds and then multiply it by 4. Normally you'd count 4 breath rates and then multiply by 4, so it would be 16 breaths per minute. And then you can either have a watch on you to measure time or there's also a clock on here. And then after you take the respiration rate, you would remove the cuff. And then you ask the patient if they're diabetic. Are you diabetic?
Yes, slightly.
Okay. And then for if they're diabetic, you're gonna take the... You're gonna have these. It's gonna be in here. So you're gonna take these out. And then the gloves are over here. You're gonna wear your gloves. And then over here, there's everything you need to take glucose. So you're gonna want to take a one-time poking needle and then alcohol prep. And then if they want, you can ask if they want a band-aid, but usually I just take a conic swab because their bleeding stops. And then you want to prepare everything beforehand. So usually I just take out the alcohol wipe. And then I take out a glucose strip. And then there's two sides to the glucose strip. So this side's the side you're going to be putting inside the machine. And then this side's the one that's going to be reading the blood. So what you do is you just stick this side in. You're gonna twist and pull. And then I'd ask if he prefers any fingers.
The middle finger.
Okay, and then I usually kind of massage a little bit to get the blood flowing. And then I'd clean his finger. If the patient has no finger preference, I usually prick the middle finger or the index finger. And then you're gonna wanna prick on the side because if you prick in the middle, there's a lot of nerve endings and it's really painful because diabetic patients have to be, they have to measure their blood glucose level multiple times a day. So I just, and then you'd hold the needle as so, you just put your two fingers here and then you just press here for the needle and then you just press. And then you just push out the blood and that should be enough. And then you're just gonna get this and then. And you're gonna see that the number starts counting backwards. And then that's when you know it's been good. And you just give him the con swab and tell him the bad pressure. So his glucose level is 95. So you just record that down. And then you'd also ask him if he ate anything this morning.
Yeah, some chicken tenders for breakfast this morning.
And a lot of times patients say no, but I also ask them if they drink anything with sugar like coffee, juice. And then what time did you eat your chicken tenders?
7:30 this morning.
And then you'd also ask their when they had their meal. And if they didn't eat this morning, it would be considered fasting blood sugar level. But if they, since he ate something, it'd be random blood sugar. For diabetic patients, it'd be a lot higher than 95. And then you just pull it out from the machine, and then you throw this inside the sharps container, which is over here. And then you throw everything else in the trash can. And then you just escort the patient out to the waiting room and tell them that the doctors will be with them shortly. And then